ready to match the star. Avery Schreiber. Brett Summer. Gary Burghoff. Arlene Francis. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75.
Yes, I am. Thank you, Johnny Olson, man.
Friend. You got a lot of friends out there, John, haven't you? Good.
Gene, would you do my income taxes?
I do your income tax? I can't even add two and two.
But you dress like H&R Block.
But I don't wear glasses on camera.
This is H&R Block. He takes off his glasses. I want to talk to him.
I never make passes at boys who wear glasses.
What's that?
Nothing. I'm just talking to myself.
I heard you say you said something. What did you say?
Girls never make passes at boys who wear glasses.
Okay, I won't wear my glasses.
Just kiss me.
Now you... No.
Thank you, dear.
My dear.
Hello.
And you.
Oh,
would you give me your lips?
You don't. Mickey Dawson won't come near me. He stayed away from me the whole week.
Oh, you've got a cold.
He doesn't want to get a rash.
Kiss you. I'm not even going to kiss you.
On my hand?
But don't even shake hands.
You, whoops.
I had, they know you.
We're losing Gene.
What do you say? I'm over here.
Great segue, Gene.
What do you say? We say hello to John Sclimenti and Sharon Walker.
How do you do?
All right, John.
Pretty good.
How much money are you winning?
$350, I think.
$350.
Mm-hmm.
Have you spent it yet in your head?
My wife has, I think.
She has? Yeah. What has she acquired so far?
She's not going to tell me. It's going to be a secret.
Good. All right. And Sharon Walker, you've had your first round question,
right.
And you matched one of our celebrities.
Right.
And his question will be long in a minute or so, but right now we got to do a little business, and this is the business we got to do. Pay attention. Here we are, all together, having a good time. Wish you were here. All right, I'll push this button and reveal this question, which belongs to John. Listen carefully, John. Here we go. Barney said, my wife is really strange looking. Last night we went to the circus, and as we were leaving, the ringmaster came up and accused me of trying to make off with the blank.
No, just
Barney was a talkative
moment.
Fellow, wasn't he?
Say it again.
Barney said, my wife is really strange looking. As last night we went to the circus, and as we were leaving, the ringmaster came up to me and accused me of trying to make off with the blank. You've been to the circus at least once in your lifetime, haven't you?
Once in a lifetime.
I think I've been with Barney's wife.
Sing it, Brett.
There's a girl out there with terrific taste in singing voices.
Brett Summers fan club here. There she is. There's your whole fan club there. Oh, you got a lot of them. There she is.
Yes.
Okay.
But I noticed...
Betty Avery.
I noticed the lady in the third row with the blue hair wasn't clapping.
All right, John, you ready?
Yeah.
Barney said, my wife is really strange looking. Last night we went to the circus, and as we were leaving, the ringmaster came up and accused me of trying to make off with the blank.
I got so many to pick from here. I think I'll say strong man.
The Romans are going to throw you to the lions. All right, he said with the strong man. There's a strong man.
Your whole family, you heard that.
Yes.
Now, I said the bearded lady.
The bearded lady. Yeah. It would have been better if you had, you know, say, lady of some kind, a bearded... What are you saying?
No, honey, I was torn... It's the minute.
Well, we won't. Go ahead, Donna, go on.
I was torn between two brilliant answers.
So she didn't write either one of them.
But I feel terrible. I thought clown or apes or ape.
Ape.
I thought that was.
Was clown your other brilliant answer?
Are you turning on me after all that swell applause we had earlier on?
Was clown your other brilliant answer?
I'm not going to tell you what my real brilliant answer was. It's too clever for this group.
Read the question. Yeah. Not for me, for Richard.
As we were leaving, the ringmaster came up and accused me of trying to make off with the...
It must have been... This is his wife, right?
Yeah.
Must have been something about her prehensile tail. I said monkey.
Monkey.
Right.
Came up and accused me of trying to make off with the monkey.
Yeah, I know, but it's...
Betty, what are you doing down there?
making off with your pants.
No, it just feels drafty. Now, all right, are you ready, Arlene?
I'm readier than you are.
I'm getting ready. Now, yes, ma'am.
My strong man happened to be a clown.
A clown? My wife is really strange looking, went to the circus, and is really the ringmaster come out and used me of trying to make off with the ta-da.
Ha 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 ha.
Oh, clown-o.
Clown-o.
You go get it.
Clown isn't bad. Well, I didn't.
Oh, when I said it, it stank, but when they say it, it's not bad.
You said ape. You went ape. You didn't go clown.
But that was one of my brilliant choices.
Oh, I see. What's your brilliant choice, Betty White, my dear lady?
Richard said there was a difference between a circus and a carnival, and that my answer belonged in a carnival.
Oh, but right, so does belonged his... in a carnival.
But so does his answer belong to... I said bearded lady, but bearded a strong lady. Man is in a carnival.
Yeah. There are bearded ladies in carnivals and in circuses, too, I guess. No. Yes, indeed.
No.
So, at this moment, in the end of round one, scores 1-0, favor Sharon. Round two coming up.
I'm going to give V one more time.
One more time. Did you have V last time?
Yeah, and I almost wiped out.
Yes. Match well. Betty, yes. Okay. The Pillsbury Doughboy got crazy drunk and tried to blank a bagel. Now, you don't watch television commercials. You don't know who the Pillsbury Doughboy is.
See you later, Gene.
Would you explain to her about the...
Yeah, just read it again, because you do it so well.
The Pillsbury Doughboy got crazy drunk and tried to blank a bagel.
It doesn't have to rhyme, does it?
No.
Well, it's not a bad idea, though, Arlene, when you think about it. Bagel rhymes with... You got me.
No, that is not the... I don't confuse her.
Well, did I say...
Like a shagel a bagel?
I mean, you know who the Pillsbury Doughboy is, don't you, Sharon? Mm-hmm. Okay.
I know who the First World War Doughboys were.
It's a cute little fellow in commercials. Very, rotund looking. Very small and rotund
and
chubby and cute and adorable.
Well, enough about me.
I guess you really have to have seen this.
Everyone needs...
Listen, we're going to send you back to New York unless you write an answer soon.
Oh, am I the one that's holding it up?
You're holding up the whole thing,
man. Oh, I'm so sorry.
That's all right.
Then we're proud of you.
Okay. Now, we are ready. Sharon Walker. The Tillsbury.
Will the aura fix lady please step to the front?
The Pillsbury Doughboy got crazy drunk and tried to blank a bagel. What do you put in that blank?
I wish I would have taken A.
But?
I wish I would have taken A.
You wish you would have taken A?
Yeah.
Well, now, you know who the Pillsbury Doughboy is, don't you?
Yeah.
Okay.
He tried to knead.
To.
As long as she needs me.
Okay, she says knead.
Well, you see, I figured that the Pillsbury getting... Well, anyhow, I figured he was trying to roll a bagel.
Trying to roll a bagel. What do you say?
I love the little Pillsbury man. He looks like Sidney Greenstreet.
He does. Remember
Peter Sidney Green
Right,
Street.
Indeed he does. Yes,
he
yes.
used to go with Peter Lorre.
Right.
I said he tried to make a bagel.
Tried to make a bagel. Well, he works at a bakery. What do you say, Gare?
Hello, Gare.
Stop trying to cover up for her.
I said, kiss and or make love to.
Kiss and or make love to. Pillsbury dope boy got crazy drunk and tried to knead a bagel, according to Sharon Walker. What is it according to Arlene?
I sort of run along the same lines as Gary. I'm romantic.
Yes.
Hug a bagel.
Hug a bagel. It's Hug a Bagel Week.
Bagel Week.
Hug a Bagel Week. Now, you, sir.
I'm surprised you need that bagel.
You need the bagel?
Low below the belt, isn't it?
Oh, right. No, that's K-N-E-A-D type. That's K-N-E-A-D type need, you know.
Ah,
as in working dough.
M-O-U-S-E, absolutely.
Yes, M-O-U-S-E, right.
Yeah, well, this guy was so juiced.
Yes.
He tried to ride a bagel.
Tried to ride a bagel.
That's
a unicycle, oh, right? Eh? No, you don't
worry for
that. You didn't do too well with that, did you, Sharon? Sorry. All right, John, your question for round two in a minute or so. But right now, friends, pay attention to this, if you would, please. All right, here we are, just having the gayest time imaginable. Yeah, there we go. Grandma Jones said to Grandpa Jones, my hearing may be bad, but your eyesight is worse. I said, speak into my ear, and you shouted into my blank. Grandma Jones said to Grandpa Jones, my hearing may be bad, but your eyesight is worse. I said, speak into my ear, and you shouted into my
bagel.
What are we doing different on this set that I keep tripping over this?
You're not lifting your legs up.
This
we're
big
doing.
Black snake-like object here. I've tripped over it twice already. Now, can't we bury that or make it go underneath or do something else? Just get that out of here. Please, cut that in two, would you please? Just cut it in two. We're waiting for you. I'm waiting to see these lights go on
here. I was trying to help Gary with his answer.
Oh. It's not allowed.
That's the blind leading the blind.
Now, all right.
I'm telling you, I will not.
I hate you, Betty.
Let's go, Brett.
No, I will not go to the motel in Encino with you, Brett.
Now, John Sclimenti. Grandma Jones said to Grandpa Jones,
my hearing may be bad, but your eyesight is worse. I said, speak into my ear, and you shouted into my...
I'm going to say nose.
Nose.
If anybody knows, speak into my ear. And he shouted in her nose. I don't understand that, but maybe you do, Avery.
I understood it so well that I screwed it up completely.
What'd you say?
I said my beer. And that has nothing to do with your eyesight.
Yes. Well, no, that's it.
That's just my...
Speak into my ear. That's good enough. Now, wait a minute.
Eyesight.
Speak into my ear, and you shouted into my beer.
It's well, all right if he had a fuzzy white face.
That's a hearing joke.
That's right.
For. We're looking for a scene.
I thought it was a hearing joke, too.
Oh, well, then I guess we're all going down the drain together, including John. What do you say?
John is aces high in my book.
Why?
Because I said no.
No! Okay. One more encounter with a proboscis, and you win the game, John. What do you say, Gare?
I say I really didn't hear this question correctly.
Oh.
I thought it was a hearing joke.
So what'd you write?
I wrote rear. Not only did I not understand the joke, but I didn't understand what good taste means.
Speak in my ear and you shouted her. I don't know about this. Anyway, we got a tie here now. Let's see if we break the tie with Arlene. A tie.
I break the tie. With Gary. I thought it was a sound-alike. Rear.
Rear. All right. Rear Richard, window. Do you break the tie?
So you have to listen carefully.
I know.
It is a scene joke we're looking for.
Yes.
Eyes have it instead of the nose.
Nose wins the game. Yeah.
another 100 for you. Congratulations. Now, aren't you a good sport to have a smile on your face, Sharon Walker?
It just feels good to get away from the kids for a while.
You what?
It felt good getting away from the kids for a while.
Well, I'm glad we were able to give you this little divertissement. And we've got a gift for you together with our thanks. Sharon Walker, it was a pleasure meeting you. Goodbye. Now, while she's spinning off, we'll spin this message for you. Come right back.
Here we are. With John Sclimenti, who now has $450, he's going to try for over $5,000 at this moment. Ready, John?
I'm ready.
Okay, we polled a recent studio audience. We got their best response to this. Voice blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250. And if you match the bottom one, you get $100. Whom do you call on over here?
I think I'll take Arlene.
I'm sorry, Arlene is taken. No, Arlene, what is your response to this?
Voice over.
Voice over.
Technical
okay.
phrase.
Yes, that's a technical phrase.
Not really. Richard?
Present. Oh.
Voice blank.
Oh, Voice of America.
Voice of America.
Very good.
Well, thank you. I'm happy with it.
All right. Now you got two.
Brett?
How about voice box?
Voice box. Yes, that's really
incredible.
An ovation there. Hello there.
That's a hard choice. I mean, I think I'll go with Brett.
Gerald Ford,
you're
going
to go with voice box. All right.
Okay. We'll find out if it's up there.
If it's there, where is it? That is the question. Is it under the $100 response? I ask you now, is it there? Okay, Earl, voice lessons. You got two dings there, eh? How come you ding twice there, Gus? You're feeling your oats there. Looking for voice box, here's a $250 response. Voice of America was Richard's response. Last chance for voice box. Here is the $500 response. Boom! Congratulations. Okay.
The pacemaker, I wonder if it's going to hold out.
You're only kidding, right?
I hope so, yeah.
What on earth made him choose box?
Listen, $950 is what you have now. And there's your wife down there. She's got her fingers, her arms crossed for you, and her fingers and her legs. And we're going to have a go now at $5,000. Remember, you have to match one celebrity head-to-head. Has to be exact.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Brett. Okay, you get ready to write.
Last chance to change your mind.
Okay, you face me if you would please, John. Here we go with the $5,000 question. Stranger in blank. Stranger in blank. Stranger in blank. Yes, of course. Put it in the slot and that's your judgment.
Oh, I'm so torn.
Brett.
What was it? Stranger what?
In blank.
Stranger in blank.
I'm sorry, I have to go with my... I changed my mind, but I've gone back to...
She mumbles a lot, John. Now... What answer would you give us in order to match Brett, who changed her mind 8 times in the 30 seconds she wrote her answer? What do you say?
The only thing I can think of is a song, Stranger in the Night.
Strangers in the Night. Is that the way that goes? Well, I will find out right now if Brett thought of that. And if she did she write it down?
I did, and I threw it out because I said, well, it's Strangers in the Night. And it's a Stranger in Paradise.
Yeah. That's true, it is.
Stranger in Paradise.
Strangers in the Night. I'll do 3 choruses if you'd like.
But right. It's Stranger in Paradises.
No.
Wrong here.
But John, you got the 915. You're going to meet another player right now and play another game. You ready?
I'm ready.
All right, let's welcome Rita Roth.
Hello,
shuffleboard.
Rita, you know John. We've all welcomed you, Rita, and we hope you feel at home here.
I do.
Would you tell us a little bit about your self, you know, your life history and where you're from and all that?
We're from Provo, Utah now. My husband and I have been married 41 years, and he's retired.
How?
But I was born in a little town of Panguitch, Utah. Do you want to know where that is?
Yes.
It's between Hatch and Paragona.
I think I'm finding out more about
you already, Rita.
Care to know there. Between Hatch and Paragona.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
I have 10 grandchildren.
You do?
And this is a recording.
That's right. Well, good luck to you, Rita. We'll begin this game right after we do a little business with America. Here we go. Just trying to say thank you and goodbye. Gene Raven, Match Game 75. Join us next time.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75, a Mark Goodsonville Tottenham production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.